Finally tonight, remembering the original Dear Abby. That's the name tens of millions of newspaper readers around the globe recognized for more than four decades. The woman behind the pen name Abigail Van Buren was Pauline Phillips, born 94 years ago in Sioux City, Iowa. She provided snappy, frank advice in a column that appeared eventually in more than 1,000 papers in its heyday before the age of the web. Amy Dickinson, who writes the advice column Ask Amy, is one of many columnists who followed in the years since, and she joins us now. Welcome to the program. What was it about Abigail Van Buren? Was it her tone, her life experience, her sympathy? What made her so credible to so many readers?
Well, you know, I think it's amazing when I think about it, because she started something over 60 years ago that's really basically still going very strong. What it is was, you know, she wasn't a doctor, she was not a psychologist, she wasn't really trained, so to speak, but what she was very practical, Midwestern, common sense, and she was really the ultimate listener. You know, people trusted her, and you could tell, you know, from reading her column that she was very genuine, she was very wise, she was super snappy, which I love, of course. And, you know, she just created a tremendous legacy.
She occasionally doled out tough love, occasionally even contacted people who wrote her that she thought might be in real trouble. Did she earn a kind of authority? You mentioned she wasn't a doctor, but she must have had some kind of authority after all that time.
Well, part of it is, you know, it's in the writing. It's the authority that your auntie has, or that smart mom next door has. You know, the idea that she would respect you while she was listening to you, and sometimes respect you enough to dole out a little smack if you needed it. You know, it's funny, just yesterday I was composing my own column, and I actually wrote the line. I wasn't aware of her passing, of course, but I wrote the line, "That's the tough part of tough love." And in a way, that line it started with Dear Abby.
Well, you could see the country and its mores changing over time through her column with the kind of things, the kind of problems that readers brought to her. Does that continue to this day? Can you see America changing in the kind of problems that Americans have?
Oh, absolutely. And when you go back, as I have done, and read her columns from the 40s, 50s, 60s, you know, they're very much a capsule of their time. The fact is, though, the questions change, but the advice really remains constant in that it's smart. Letters I get, I mean, I probably get 50 queries a day about Facebook, about social media and its impact on relationships. But the advice I give, it's grounded in the sorts of things that Dear Abby was talking about in the 50s and 60s.
You know, Amy, when you replaced Ann Landers in the Chicago Tribune, in fact, Dear Abby's sister, her twin sister yet, there was no question that the paper was going to find another advice columnist and keep the franchise going. The only question was who was going to do it, and you were chosen. Why is it in this day and age, in 2013, when there's so many sources for so many kinds of information, that it's felt that that's an essential component of a newspaper?
I just think that this is a genre that's really tried and true. And Ray, you know, where would we be if you opened your newspaper to the back and the jumble and the comic strips and the crossword puzzle, and where would you be if you didn't see an advice column there? You know, it's very much a part of what we've come to expect in newspapers. And frankly, it's about the only place in a newspaper where readers really communicate directly with the writer.
You mentioned that you sort of went to school on Abigail Van Buren's columns over the years. Are there any that stand out today, or her ways of handling things that stick with you and you may have even modeled yourself after?
Well, mainly it's sort of this genuine honesty that I felt she conveyed really well. There was also a lot of compassion. And I think it's very easy to sort of stand up there and tell people what to do, but to do it with warmth and kindness and compassion while still occasionally, you know, serving up a nice helping of tough love, you know, that's tricky. And she was a master.
Amy Dickinson writes the Ask Amy column for the Chicago Tribune and syndicated papers all around the country. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you.